Hey everybody. Playing a little Trans-Siberian Orchestra tonight. Oh, I can hear a double kick on that. Heck yeah. Can't believe we didn't do that. Why did the drummer not do that? Anyway, hope you're all having a good Monday. Mine's alright. Oh, it was a mess. Yeah, computer programs going down on me all day at work. My one coworker is out on medical leave. Won't see her hopefully till next year. She's my problem child, so she can. I'm not gonna work here anymore, as far as I'm concerned. Oh. I gotta say, I keep gaining. People, I keep gaining followers while I'm not online. So I gotta say hi to Omicron 416 followed me 21 hours ago. Hey Omicron. So thanks for following. I appreciate it. Hey, tonight we're gonna continue working on, guess what? The Lilith bust. Almost said Lilith Fair. No, we're not working on Lilith Fair. I don't think they would let my band on Lilith Fair. Yeah. Too many guys in the band, not enough girls. As in, there's no girls. Not that I wouldn't mind having a girl in the band. We could find a really, really great lead guitar player. We get rid of Shashir. No, I'm kidding. I like the guy. I love the guy. He's a brother. Been with the band for 15 years. But, you know, every once in a while, man. Should we do a... Let's do a chest. Let's see if this camera's working. I have a feeling it's not. Nope, still not working. Camera turns on. Doesn't work. Isn't uploading the data. My computer is telling me bugger off. Ah, come on. Get the lens cap back on there, you bugger. So anyway, we're going to continue work on Lilith here. And it feels like I'm back in like my first year. Oh, here's my webcam. Right? Whoop. I didn't want that. Hell, there we go. Okay, I'm trying to get that back into frame here. But yeah, we're gonna work on Lilith more tonight. I think we probably have a couple more, 3-4 hours. I still gotta do the feathers here. I gotta figure out what to do with the border on the fabric. We gotta give the armor color, because that it looks good, but it needs some something. So I've got some blue tone over here, and I got some green tone over here, and the blue tone I think I'm gonna put on the aged pewter armor. And then the green tone I'm going to put on the old bronze that we use. And then we're going to mess around. You won the war in a foreign land.
never preached, though he always knew. And we watched him close, just to pick up clues, and sometimes late in the dead of night, I can see him there in the pale moonlight. I am trying, and I don't know how, and I don't know when, but I have to tell him someday.
So we're just going to give this some nice washes here. Pretty cool. This green tone works really well over this old bronze, because the old bronze has a little bit of green in it anyway. So you can kind of see that real nice shaded tone to it. We gotta let that dry now before we do anything else to it. I think I want to give it a little bit of patina-ing. I'm going to give it a patina, is what we're going to do. Blue shading. Oh, we gotta get back in there. It's okay. We can do a little of that little blue shading back in there too. Through here, like that. Oh. I almost forgot about this part. There's some bronze back in here, so we gotta green that up a little bit. There we go. I think that's the end of that album. There's only 5 songs. Which is fine. Gonna grab a little bit more blue, and I wanna go right in through here. We also gotta get that neck piece here. You know, that last song, I was just thinking that would make a really great lullaby. I was just thinking, you know, when I have grandkids, I want to play that for them. I got to remember that. Let's see if I do. Just wondering if there's anywhere else I could put this. Let's add a little bit of blue right back in here. Again, more of a filter. We're still kind of working on the skin. Like we're dinking around with it. We're seeing what we can do. Back underneath the chin here. So it's almost kind of reflecting the blue from her necklace up onto her neck. It'll probably blend in here, but just a little bit in the horns here. Just through there. Oh, excuse me, I got the hiccups there. A bit of blue in that area here. Once again, kind of giving her that kind of otherworldly look. Still don't know what I want to do with her eyes yet. We've done a lot of blue-gray and blues and grays and stuff like that, so I'm trying to decide how I want to do the feathers. I think I have an idea. I think I have an idea. So I'm going to grab some royal purple. And I don't like the name of it, but it's called Witchcraft Purple. Pretty good looking purple. I don't like the name of it just because I'm not into it. That's not my shtick. So grab some of the royal purple. I have an idea. I wonder if I can do this, if I'm going to topple everything. Oh no, I'm going to topple everything because it's wrapped around that. Oh, nope, good, we're good. If I go... Turka, this way. Oh, see, I'm probably not going to work. And you can see my horrible mess of my desk. So you can see what I'm doing, or at least try to see what I'm doing. Then you can also see my palette too. I can't see what I'm doing, but you can. You can barely make it out, but it is there. You can see, actually, you can see it better on the screen than you can actually in person. But that's the royal purple on those feathers. Now we're going to go into the witchy one. It's kind of hard to see. Wolf's Fox, how you doing, my friend? You're probably wondering why my camera setup looks like this. It's because this camera, my DSLR, my computer is no longer picking it up. I was told by my computer guy on Saturday that my little MacBook here can't be upgraded anymore. It is done. And even though I have a nice, like, what is it, seven? It's like 7 or 8 port thing here. It's just not upgrading anymore. It just won't. It had been attacked by some malware as well, which is why I had him over. And I went to go plug it back in, and it'll pick up this just fine. It'll grab this one. but it will not pick up my other one. Now that might be OBS, not updating or anything like that. So yeah, I got blue hands. I feel like Firefly. So I'm trying it like this. I had the camera over there. And now I'm trying it in front of me, which makes it a wee bit more difficult to paint. But at least I kind of have like a hand rest right here with the tripod. So that's kind of nice. But you can't really see a lot of the details that I'm putting on right now. And that kind of sucks. But I'm trying to get these little feathers. And I've added in just a bit of light, warm gray into my purple. So I can get a little bit more of a highlight going here. Oh, good. You saw the Facebook pics. Good, good. Yeah, those definitely turn out better than what I've got going on here, but two by two hands of blue. Anyway. Yes, I am a Firefly fan. I wish there were more episodes. I liked the movie. Serenity was good. But if you think about it, they actually, like Josh Whedon and a few others, started putting out Firefly stuff in comic book form. So if you really want more Firefly stuff, go read a comic book. Go read. Here's my PSA for the day. Go read. Hey kids, get off the internet, go read. Go read a book. I got the first kid on bike done as well. Felt pretty good about that one. If you want to know what I looked like back in the 80s, that's pretty close. Except not as handsome and a little chubbier. Now I'm a lot chubbier and I'm still not as handsome. It's all right, my wife likes me. There we go. I think that's it. I think that's all I'm going to do on those feathers. I did have red tennis shoes. Though, I did have red tennis shoes. And I did have a neon green bike that let me do sweet BMX tricks on it. So, there's that. I think my washes are finally dry. Woohoo. Okay, so now we are gonna, this is kind of a blue-green, this is what I'm using for my my tarnish, my, what do you want to call it, patina. So we're just gonna water this down until it's super thin. People at home, don't freak out. I'm wondering if this is going to be too much. Maybe one more. Don't worry, folks. I'm a professional. So I did this green wash over it, right? Now I'm putting this, it's a very pretty color. Yeah, I wish I knew exactly what it was called, but it's just a sample color that I got from Reaper. But we're just putting it kind of all over our old bronze here. It's super thin down. But then you get a little bit more in, right in through there. The first time I saw somebody do this, I was like, what are you doing? Yeah, I really haven't done too much of the taking any photos of the backside. I'll do that once I'm actually completely done with it. And I will get photos of both the front and the back. But yeah, she's got this cool headdress thingy on with this veil down the back. This isn't her hair. This isn't hair. She's actually just, it's all horns with this headdress on, this veil. So you can see now, as it's drying, it's leaving this greenish blue patina in the areas here. Like, this is actually too much right in through here. I need to move that. I could still do that. There's too much back in there. But since I can still move it around, I can move it up where, or down where water would collect. Moisture, I guess I should say. Not so much water, but where moisture would collect and create that patina effect. Right in through there. So if you give me just a second, I'm going to turn my microphone off. I'm actually going to dry this so we can keep going. So hold on. I'm fine. Glad I had my microphone off, though. There was a there were words said. So if you can see it now, you can see me now. You're taking a leave from me. Anyway, all in through there, you can see, you should be able to see some of that patina-ing all in that armor, right in through here. Get it further away. Anyway, right in through here, and through here. But yeah, there's her back. So her corset thing is actually open, because this is her spine. She's got little horny knobs coming out of her back, and then these horns coming out. There's horns everywhere on this lady. But yeah, we've patina all in through here. And now we go back to our old bronze, which we got a pile of from last night. Just gonna touch up a couple spots here. Mostly the edges. Through here. What's my favorite thing I've painted lately? Ooh, that's a good question. Normally when I answer that question, like, what's your favorite thing you've painted? It's normally the thing that I'm currently working on. Because the thing that's putting, I'm putting the most attention into. We'll have to say that the Beholder was a lot of fun. Puck the Adventuring Kobold was a lot of fun. Starting to work on the Kids on Bikes figures. I'll have those posted before Con of the North. Because I gotta get those done. For Jeffy. For Hefe. Okay, so I reintroduced the old bronze while leaving the patina in there. So now, wonder if I still have some. I gotta see if I have a brighter bronze. If I have a weapons bronze here. Ha-ha. Want copper. See, now that's a completely different bronze. What you're saying is that you've had some great minis lately. I have. I've had some really great minis lately. Yeah, a lot of good ones. The 3D prints, I think, are going to be some of my favorites. Lilith here is really fun. I mean, so I don't know if you'll be able to see this or not, but this is one of the Kids on Bikes. She's roller skating. And then I've got I got two other kids that actually have bikes. This is going to be a good one. I think I'm going to, Jeff's asking for one that's a chrome bike, so I think I'm going to do this one in complete chrome. Very, very shiny silver. I think this one here, this is a girl with a bike. She's got these cool fenders on her bike. And so I'm thinking about doing hers. I don't want to do like super girly colors, but I don't know, maybe some purples and yellows or something like that, just to make it punch a little bit. I'm going to do some research on like girls' bikes, 80s girls' bikes. This guy's kind of fun. He's a 3D print, actually. He's holding a walkie-talkie and wearing a nice coat with like the cool 80s striped shirt. And then this one here is just funky looking because he's got like other stuff. Like he's got rollerblades, and rollerblades I don't believe were around in the 80s yet, per se. They might have been. But then he's got like the, he's a 3D print too. But he's blowing a bubble. He's eating bubble gum. And then this one here, of course, is our skater dude. With the mullet. With the mullet going. The puffy jacket. Riding the skateboard. So yeah, I got some fun figures coming up. There's the other thing too. He wanted one of them to be have more Asian skin. He also wanted one to have be African American, which I did the roller skating girl as African American skin. We'll do a few others. I like doing different skin tones, so. So if you can tell, here is our old bronze. Very kind of this greenish beat up bronze, which is what we got on here. This is our weapons bronze. Very much more red and bright and shiny. Very much a contrast compared to our old bronze there. I'm going to dip any more of that in there. But we're going to take this and again just run the edges here. Oh, I lost a follower. Somebody didn't. I was at 371. And somebody left. Son of a gun. They said this stuff is lame. I'm out. Sometimes I really wish I could see who did that, like who left. So I could ask him why and send him a message. Why'd you leave? What didn't you like? What could I change? Is it the fact that my other camera's not working because I need a new computer? That's out of my control right now. I gotta save up and buy a new computer. Then I have to frickin' upload everything again. Oh, it just irritates me. You have no idea how badly that irritates me. I have to upload OBS again. I gotta bot clean up, maybe. Possibly bot clean up, that'd be alright. Oh, it's only Monday. Well, it's Monday's almost over, so. We're on the home stretch, though, folks. We're getting closer to Christmas. This Sunday. I can't believe it. Christmas Day already. It doesn't feel like the holidays because there's no snow on the ground. Kim's been lamenting that. Kim's my wife. She's been lamenting that for weeks now. She's like, we should have snow. It's not Christmas without snow. I'm like, well, it's still Christmas. There's no snow. I'm like, welcome to Seattle. Throughout my high school years, this was what Christmas looked like for me. No snow. All rain. On my personal Facebook page, I've been trying to post, like, hey, 1 week till Christmas. You got your holly jollies out yet? Got your Frosties out? If you've never seen Christmas at the Cranks, you should watch it a couple times. It's pretty good. Not my favorite Christmas movie, but it's pretty good. Kim likes it, so we watch it. I, of course, have my Christmas shirt ready for family Christmas on Saturday. It's my Christmas vacation shirt. Can't wait. I have two shirts from Tee Public that are Christmas vacation based. I can't wait to wear them. It's going to be awesome. One has the Clark Griswold rant of how he wants his boss, Mr. Shirley, brought in. With a big face of Clark on the front of it. And then the other one is the eggnog mug, moose mug. Says, can I get you anything else? More eggnog? Food? Take you out in the middle of nowhere, leave you for dead? Yeah, I'm thinking about wearing that one to family Christmas. Yeah, the middle of nowhere, maybe for dead. Where was I going here? I need to grab some silver. Let's go with some blade steel. And I know that we've kind of shinied this up a little bit, but we're just going to take a little bit of blade steel. Hit some of the points. Just to make it a little bit shinier. Not a lot. I'm also going to do this here. That I may dry brush real quick, actually. you can see, I'm trying to use the side of my brush to get the ridges here painted. How much I can do. And grab this brush. I'm just gonna get a real quick dry brush here. A little bit of Snowdrift White here. Put some of these paints away. And we got to do these little borders around the fabric here. I need to correct myself. I said Sunday was Christmas Day. I should have said Sunday is Christmas Eve. Christmas Day is Monday. just gonna make this look a little bit more like fabric. Let's see, what else do I need to do here? The eyes. So we're going to use this Imperial Fist contrast paint as the initial coat for the eyes. And these aren't the eyes here, these are the eyes right here. That's just the lower eyelid. That's pretty creepy looking. Sorry, I keep bumping the camera. My apologies. And then we're going to take some Yandan Yellow, which is a little bit more orange yellow. top. Let that dry. Just a little bit of coal black here. And then she's got dry. It shouldn't take too long. Find a spot here. Just a drop of solid white. Spot there, and a spot there. Okay. See, she is, for the most part, as far as I'm concerned, done. I just need to do the base. So, So I went and I grabbed a sponge. And I grabbed some hunter green paint. I also grabbed some jade green. And I'm just going to get off some of the excess paint here that I have all over my face. This is another reason to wear gloves when you're painting. We're just going to take this sponge and sponge all over the base here. This is going to give us a nice texture here for our marbling. So we've got that on. I'm gonna let that dry now. So that was our hunter green. Now we're going to take some jade green, and not using a super wet sponge, take some right from the cap here. So, just got a little bit. Once again, kind of dab that off on our paper towel here. And that's dry already. That's one thing I love about craft paints, is they're dry already. You see how that jade green goes over the top of our hunter green. lose me over here? Hey, Wolf Fox, have a, it's all time off. Oh, geez, see, I missed a bunch of chats here. I missed a bunch of chats. Because my page wasn't working. Wolf Fox, I'm sorry I missed your good night, but good night, sleep well. So the same green that we used, blue green that we used for the patina, we can now use for creating our lines. think we've done enough damage on the base there to make it look like marble. And with that, folks, I think I'm going to call Lilith done. And she will be available at Con of the North. So, hope you all have a wonderful rest of your evening. I'll be back on Wednesday for some more painting. And I think on Wednesday we are going to start on this guy, just because he's a nice big bust and we can do some cool skin stuff with him. So, I hope you all have a great rest of your week, or great next day. We'll see you on Wednesday. As always, happy painting, folks. Bye.